Charles Wakabulindi supported the redevelopment of the stadium by businessman Hamis Chigundu in 2015 after FIFA banned it from hosting international games while he was the state minister for sports. Wakabulindi today toured construction works at Nachivubo Stadium to acquaint himself with the progress of the project.
I've any regret at all. Instead, I praise myself that historically I will be praised that I'm the minister who started it.
The construction budget increased partly due to their pursuit to end more flooding at the stadium, which was a major case before renovation.
You when look at the nature of the work, knowing very well the history of Nachivubo, how it used to be a wetland, how it used to be a place of always flooding, a lot of money had to be sunk here. To start 4-5 meters down to bring it to the level we are. When I look at it now, and I look at the way the structure has started, because this is what they have been showing me since morning, how they are going to increase the levels of seating, how they have even accommodated the prestigious boxes, which we used to meet outside, not here. Eh? How the indoor stadium games are being accommodated, the entries, and how the parking is going to be, to me, I'm convinced, I'm seeing that there is light where we are going.
Currently, they're still compacting the base for the fish turf before they add another quarter-inch aggregate, which is about 2 inches thick, and which will also be compacted to level until the required slope according to the FIFA recommendations, which is 1%. Wakabulindi appealed the country to trust more local investors on such projects.
As we were talking about BMK, more investors, let them come out, and government to start a system of even treating the local investors better than the foreigners. If we are giving tax holidays, and let it be a kick of encouraging the local investors to be serious. Because for them, they are here, they are not running away. Like others who come here and start something, do a shoulder work. If it is construction of the road, it takes only 3 years, and they have already gone, but the investor is around, and there is a guarantee for it. I think, to me, this is a very good signal for some investors who are local to be encouraged, to be nurtured and to be motivated.
On completion, the new Nachivubo will remain unique in its nature with different and unique amenities like lifts for physically handicapped, cinema halls, an area for indoor games like table tennis and pool, VIP boxes which can be booked by a group of people on top of ordinary seating, VVIP and executive boxes on the first tier. The executive boxes seat about 20 people each, with extra amenities like self-contained laboratories, sofa sets, a conference room, and a resting area.